Hello friends, welcome to Dev's Institute. Today we are going to see basic assembly language program. This is structure of assembly language program. First part contains assembler directives, which includes memory model declaration. Then next is data section, and then latter comes the code section. As you may be writing C program, C++ program, you know that your program basically contains a data and a code, and code operates on this data. Here also there are same things, code and data, and there are some assembler directives which directs assembler about the code and about the program. So assembler directives are basically to represent the memory model, means which memory model to use, where to store the program, what will be the size of page, likewise. So these are not executable statements, these are just directions to the assembler. Like we write preprocessor directives in C program, here we write assembler directives, as this is assembly level program. First we'll see assembler directives. Basically we'll just focus on memory model declarations, because memory model declarations are must in any program. Other assembler directives I have discussed in other videos. Memory models. So there are 5 different memory models. Now what is memory model? We know that every program consists of a code memory and a data memory. So when we write assembly language program, so now see, we are writing assembly language program, it is middle level language, it is not high level language. So we are moving closer towards machine, and because of this we have to give instructions in detail to the machine, because we don't have a compiler in between. We are going to directly submit our program to assembler, so we are moving one step towards machine. So it is middle level language. So in memory there are 5 different memory models. Memory models basically define the size for code segment and code section and data section. We know that program contains code section and data section. In high level language this all care will be taken by the compiler, but now here we have to define the size for the code and the data. So first is the small memory model. When we define memory model as a small, then we can store code in one segment and data in one segment, means your code should fit in one segment memory and your data should fit in one segment memory. It should not be more than, or it should not go beyond one segment. Now what is segment? If you know the basics of computer organization, or if you have studied any microprocessor, then we know that memory is divided into a small blocks called as a segment. So here I am talking about that segment. So a segment size can be different based on the microprocessor. So here small memory model mean code should be placed in one segment, data should be placed in one segment, they cannot go beyond one segment. In medium, your code can go beyond one segment, code can use more than one segment, but data should be in one segment. Compact, code should be in one segment, but data can go beyond one segment. And in large, code can go beyond one segment, data can go beyond one segment size, but array, if you are declaring any array in the program, that should not be more than 64 KB. And in huge, code can be on one segment, data can go beyond one segment, and also array size can be larger than 64 KB. So for academic purpose, we are dealing with very small programs and basic program. So we are going to use the small memory model. So first statement of our program will be dot model small, where dot model is the assembler directive which talks about the memory model, and small is the memory model which we are going to use. So by this statement we are telling that our code will fit in one segment and our data will fit in one segment. They will not go beyond one segment, as we are dealing with a small program, basic program. Okay, so by this assembler will assign a one segment for data and one segment for code. Then next comes the data section. So like we declare variables in our C++ program, high level language program, here also we need to define some variables because we need those variable for internal calculation purpose or storing the intermediate results. Okay, so in assembly language program, what we are going to do, we are going to read data from the memory and we are going to write data to the memory, but for in between operations or for in between calculations we require some variables. Okay, so these are basic data types that we use in assembly language program. DB is a define byte, define word, define double word, define quad word and define 10 bytes. So first is DB, that is define byte. So as name suggests, byte size is 1 byte. Okay, 1 byte, you know, it is equal to 8 bits. Next is define word. So word means 2 bytes. Define double word. Double word is 2 words, that is 4 bytes. Define quad word, 8 bytes, and define 10 bytes. So it is size is 10 bytes. So like we have integer, float, character in the C++, here we have define byte, word, double word, quad word and 10 bytes. Okay, so here this is our first statement, dot model small for memory model declaration. Then we have data section. Our data section starts with data, dot data. So every statement that has a dot in a start is a assembler directive, not executable statement. Those are just directions to the assembler. So now we are telling assembler that my data section is starting from this point onwards. So dot data is a start of data section. Then we have declared one variable, str DB and welcome. So now str is my variable, is name given by me, str. DB is a define byte which we have seen here, define byte DB, and the string which I have stored is a welcome and dollar at the end. Dollar at the end defines the end of string. Like we use slash zero, null character in C++, here we use dollar to define the end of the string. So str is my variable name given by me. You can write str, you can write str1, you can write my string, whatever. Then db is the data type, and welcome is my string. Now see here, DB I have written in small case, here it is in capital case, capital letters. So assembly language program is not case sensitive. So if you write DB in small case, then also it is okay. If you write DB in capital, that is also okay. So no problem about the case. Like in C program it is case sensitive, this is not case sensitive. Okay, so now next we'll go towards the code section. So now we have this memory model statement, we have data ready. I have only one string defined, string which is type of byte, define byte, and string is welcome. See, we don't have any semicolon here. Like C program, we don't have any semicolon here. We'll come to semicolon. Semicolon is actually used to write comment in the assembly language program. So next is the code section. So code section again will start with dot code. So dot code represents the start of code section. First statement is main proc, that is main procedure. As every program has a main procedure and execution starts from main procedure, here also we'll have a main function, that is main procedure, from where the execution will start. Like you write void main in C program, here you write main proc. Then next statements. So here main proc and your main procedure will start, no curly braces, nothing. Move ax comma at the rate data, move ds comma ax. Now these two statements are very important, and now we'll talk about these two statements. Okay, these two statements are used for data segment initialization purpose. So before going towards data segment, we'll first see what is this ax. Okay, so ax, in microprocessor we have register to store the data. So here we have general purpose registers A, B, C, D. These registers are 32 bit long. Okay, so that 32 bit long register, A register accumulator, is called as EAX. So when we call EAX, it is 32 bit register. But if you don't want to use 32 bit register, and if your data is 16 bit, you can use only lower 16 bits of data, and we call that register as AX. Okay, so I repeat, when you call EAX, it is entire 32 bits of accumulator. When you call AX, it is lower 16 bits of the accumulator. But if you want to use only 8 bit data, that is 8 bit register, then this AX is again divided into two 8 bit register. The lower one is called AL, and this one, higher 8 bits, are called AH. Okay, so again I repeat, EAX is a 32 bit, AX is a 16 bit, and AH and AL are 8 bit registers. So our first instruction is move AX comma at the rate data. So now by AX I mean 16 bit, and at the rate data will give us the starting address of the data section. Now we know that our data is stored in one memory segment because we have defined small memory model. At the rate data will give me the starting address of that segment. Starting address of the segment I will store in AX register. In 80, I am talking about this program with respect to 80386 microprocessor. So in 80386 microprocessor, addresses are always 16 bit. So at the rate data will return me this 16 bit address, starting address of the data section, that I am going to store in AX, because AX is a 16 bit register. And then next instruction is move DS comma AX, that is I am moving that 16 bit address from AX register to DS register. Now what is DS register? DS register is a data segment register. So like we have general purpose register, we have segment registers. Segment registers are of 16 bit size. CS is a code segment register, SS is a stack segment register, DS is a data segment. Similarly, ES and GS are also for data segment. So this is a DS register where we are going to store the starting address of the data section. Okay, so what we have done here, first we have moved @data means the base address of the data section to AX register, and from AX register we have moved that address to DS register. So by this way our DS register is initialized. That means our data segment register is initialized. Our data segment register now contains the address of our data section, my program's data section. So now why this? See, we are moving first the address into AX, from AX into DS. Why this? We cannot do directly. Why we cannot write directly move DS comma @data and move directly address? Because it is external memory address and we cannot move data directly from external memory to segment registers. It should be from the general purpose registers. Okay, so later when we'll see more and more programs, you will get to know about this. So for time being, just remember that move AX comma @data, move DS comma AX. These are used for data segment initialization purpose, and these two statements will appear as the first two statements of your program. Then these statements will be followed by all your code which you want to perform, and then so we'll come to this section later, and then the last two statements of program will be move AH comma 4CH INT 21H. This is to terminate the program. Okay, so now what is this? By this move AH comma 4CH INT 21, move AH comma 4CH. Now we know AH register. AH register is a 8-bit register, higher 8 bits of the AX register. Okay, so AH register is 8-bit register, and I am moving this 4C value 4C to the AH register. So by this I am just moving 4C value to AH register, and then INT 21H. Now what is INT 21H? INT 21H is the interrupt number 21. H is for hexadecimal. 21 and interrupt 21H, what it does, the job of interrupt 21H is to check the code stored in AH register. Okay, to check the code stored in AH register and work accordingly. So now this instruction will store 4C into AH register, and the next instruction is INT 21H. So what INT 21H will do? It will check the value stored in AH. Now what we have in AH? We have in AH 4C, value 4C. Now what is the meaning of 4C, or what is the job of 4C? Job of 4C is to terminate the process, end of processing. Okay, so this will terminate our program. So simply this is used for program termination. And then last two statements are main end P, main proc. Here it is starting of main procedure, and here will end P. End P is end procedure. So main is our name of procedure, main end P, and end main, that is end of the entire program. Okay, so this is all about the structure. So now what our program basically contains? It contains four section. First one is data segment initialization, then your actual code, then end of processing by move AH comma 4CH INT 21H, and then program end statement. Okay, so these four sections will be there. So this you have to write, this you have to write, this you have to write, and in between you have to write your code. So now see here, semicolon and all code means this is a comment. So you are in assembly language program, comment starts with semicolon. Anything which is starting with semicolon is considered as a comment, and it will not be executed. Okay, so this is all about the structure of assembly language program. Now we'll see a program to print welcome message on the screen. Program to print welcome message. So now we know dot model small is the memory model. Then dot data strdb welcome dollar is the string which we have defined in data section. Then our code dot code main proc mu ax comma at the rate data mu ds comma ax for the initialization of data segment. Then comes your code, will come to this letter. Then we have mu ah comma 4ch int 21h for termination of code, main end p end main. Now what is written in my code? Okay, so we have to print welcome message on the screen. So first instruction in this code is lea dx comma str. So here lea is the instruction to load effective address. Okay, lea means load effective address. So by this instruction, what we are doing, we are loading effective address of str into dx register. So like we have ax register, the size of ax register is 16 bit. So like we have dx, edx, dx, dh, dl. So here dx register is used. DX register is 16 bit. We know that addresses are of 16 bit, so we are moving address of str, lea load effective address dx comma str. So load effective address of str into dx. So DX register will contain the address of str. Next instruction is mu ah comma 09h. So we are moving 09h into ah register. DX register is 16 bit, ah register is 8 bit. Then we are executing instruction int 21h. Now we know that int 21h, job of int interrupt 21h is to execute code in ah. Now what is in ah? 09h. Now what code 09h do? The job of 09h to display a string on a screen, because that's what we have to do now. We have to print welcome message. To job of 09h is to display a string on screen whose address is present in DX register. Okay, so now 09h, what it will do, it has to print the screen whose address is present in DX register. So now it will look into the DX register. Now DX register contain the address of str. Now what is str? What is stored in str? At str we have stored welcome string. So it will print the welcome message on the screen. Again I repeat, job of 09h, code 09h is to display a string on screen whose address is present in DX register. So now our DX register contain address of str, because with this instruction we have moved the str address into DX register. So now it will print the welcome message on the screen. And then the last for termination of the program, mu ah comma 4ch int 21h. So again 4c will be moved to h register, interrupt 21h. It will look for code in h, it is 4c. So terminate the program, and then main end p and end main. So this is all about the welcome structure of a assembly language program, and how to print a welcome message on the screen. So I hope you have understood the concept of assembly language program and basic instructions and basic statements of a assembly language program. If you like video, please press like button given below the video, and if you have any queries, you can ask me through comment section. Thank you.